For keto-approved yogurt, you will need 2 quarts of half and half, 1 cup of whole vitamin D milk, and 1 cup of a starter. The 2 quarts of half and half go in first, along with 1 cup of whole milk. The rest of it will be held until after it has cooked. Make sure that when you're cooking, you have an aluminum pan and a wooden spoon. It's very important because the metals can mess with it. When you start cooking, you have to get it up to 185 degrees. Go slow or it'll scorch, and then you put it into the oven. And in the oven, it stays for about 30 minutes at 185 degrees. Don't touch it, don't open it, nothing. Just leave it completely alone. When it's done, bring it out and let it cool down to at least 110 degrees Fahrenheit. At that point, you can then stir in your 1 cup of active culture yogurt or 1 cup from your last batch. You stir it very well. Then you put it into your containers and you put that into the oven. Turn off the oven. Do not have it keep going. Turn on the light. Keep the light on. And go for at least 8 hours. You want to have at least 8 hours. Average is about 12. If you go 24 hours, it'll get more sour, but it'll be very dense. Once it's done, you take it out of the oven, let it cool. It should be very thick in consistency. You could be able to turn it upside down, in fact, and it won't go anywhere. Put it in the refrigerator. When you're ready to eat, take out 1 cup at a time. You can put other things in it. This actually has a jam, which doesn't make it keto, but you can put fruit.